Okay, today I'm going to be talking about how to start photo book from scratch. How to design a photo book from scratch. Now, the software I'm using is Pixelu Smart Album. You can get it from Getting to PC or MacWorld.com. I can't remember where I downloaded for Mac, but for Windows, you can get from Getting to PC.com. So, I'll be using Pixelu Smart Albums for it. Now let me just go straight into it. So when you open your Pixelu Smart Album, you should have your interface is supposed to look like this. So what I'll just do is I'll click on new. Right, when I click on new, I'll forget about everything here and go to custom. Now this gives me the liberty to input the dimensions that I want. So if you are doing 10x20, 9x18, 9x36, whichever size, here you can just input it. Now for my DPI, I always use 200. Okay, the higher the DPI, the higher the size of the photo book when you are done. So 200 is a safe resolution for me. They always come out nice. 300 comes out nice also. You get just that the size is usually larger. Let's say by the time I'm done with 200, the total photo book size might be 250 MB, but when I'm done, when I use 300, it's going to be higher, obviously, maybe like 400 MB or so. You get, so I use 200 DPI. Make sure your unit is in inches. Right, now this is where you input this spread width and spread height is where you input the sound. I'm getting notifications from my phone. So this is where you input the size of your photo book. So let's take, for example, I want to do a 12x24, a 12x24 photo book, which is 12x12. You get, so it's 12x12 when closed, then when open it's 12x24. Same way, if I'm doing a 10x20, it's 10x10 when closed, then 10x24 when open. So for example, okay, let me just show you guys something. So let's take, for example, this is my photo book here, yeah? And this is a 10x10. Now when you open it, it becomes 10x20 in terms of sizing. So when it's closed it's 10x10, when it's open it's 10x20, right? So now for my spread width, I'm going to be putting the entire size when it's open, which is 24. So let's say I'm doing 12x24. I'm going to be inputting 24, which is when it is opened, right? So I'll change my spread width to 24. Then my spread height, which is from up to down, is not, you can't close up to down, right? You can only open from left to right. So from up to down, I know it's 12 inches. I'm not changing anything on that. So my spread height will be 12 inches. So I have 24 here and I have 12 here. Now if you know your photo book is going to be, let's say 10x18 when open, when you open it, it's going to be 10x18, right? On your spread width you impute 18, and then on your spread height you'll impute 10, right? Then all of this I just leave at 0, trim 0, save zone 0, layout 0, include full spread templates, make sure it's checked, then click on next. So here, template library and appearance settings, I'll make sure I have all templates selected. Now border around images, when you input your, when you bring in your image, do you want to have a border around it? So let's take, for example, I input a picture, right? Let's take, for example, I input a picture. I don't know if you can see it, but if you can't, let me just still explain. Now let's take, for example, I input a picture, right? Now do you want a border around this picture? That's what this border around image is simply means. Do you want a border around every picture that you put in? So I add border to my own, a white border. But if you don't, you can just click on none, right? Or if you want to add border, you can just click on medium, thick, depending on how thick you want the border to be. Then gap between images. What's the space you want? Like how much space do you want between images? draw an image to. So when you put an image side by side, that space in between them, how big do you want it to be? So I'm using 2, but you can make it bigger. But if you make it bigger, it needs more space. If you use extra thin, 4. You can use extra thin, you can just keep it at 4. Then keep your border around images at 0. If you want to add border around images, depending on how big you want, you click here. And then you change your border around images color. You can use whatever color you feel works for you. But I'm using white. So I'll just bring it down back to white. Or click on none. Let me use none. Oh no, let me use so that when I do it, you see what C actually is. So let me use thick. Then let me use red. Okay. Now, spread background color. What's the color of your spread? It's usually white. Usually white. But then you can still change. I'm getting it. It's distracting me. But then you can still change your background color. But let's just leave it as white. Now, next thing you do, you click on start. Okay. So when you click on start, it's going to ask you where do you want to save your photo book. So you can just create a new folder. I'm just going to create a new folder here and just name it sample book. Sample book. Right, let me copy it. Create. Now here you can increase the file name of your photo book. You can leave it at my new project, or you can still leave it at sample book. Then you click on save, and then it's going to load up. Alright, now you can look for where your pictures are, the pictures you want to use for your photo book. So let me just check for any picture that I have. Okay, let me just use this one. So, let me just use everything. I didn't want to bring in everything before. But if you know the pictures you want to use, you can just click on the folder and just drag it into it. But I don't want to use everything from here, so I'm just going to select. I just want to select like a few images. Sorry. I just want to select like a few images from here. So let's say this is all I'm using. And then just drag it into Pixel Smart Album. So you wait for it to load up. All the pictures are going to come into Smart Album. So let's give it a few moments. Alright, so let's say your pictures are now on Pixelu. Now first thing you want to do is go to your filter, because now my images are scattered, right? It's not following the way I shot them, so they are scattered. So I'll just come to filter and then sort by file name, and then make sure the pictures are arranged as to how you shot them in terms of beginning to end. You get what I'm trying to say? Or you check time modified. Let me see. Okay, that's time modified. Check file name. Just sort by file name, so everything will flow the way you shot them. Now, this is your workspace. These are your images, right? These are your individual images. Okay. So you now start designing. Now, how I usually design is, like I said, I try to tell the story of the events, even on the photo book, right? Let's something that happened at the end must come at the beginning. Do you understand? So if it's wedding, I usually start with accessories and makeup. If that's how I shot it, accessories and makeup. So I can just infuse, bring in this one. You can drag in, or you can just double click on it. It's going to open up. Double click on it. It's going to open up. Double click. Double click. So I'm just going to like select through. I'm not putting in every single image. I'm just going to like scan through and select. So I'll bring this in. Bring this in. Bring this in. Now I try to also not fill it up with so many images so it doesn't get boring. The highest I can put in a photo book is 12 pictures. And that's usually when I'm doing group photographs, because group photographs most times are usually much. So I try to like just put in 12, you get. So from here now, once you've applied in your images, now you see this white line here. This is a divider. This is to show you that this is the middle of
your photo, right? This is the middle of your photo, so you have to be conscious with the pictures that come in here. So you don't want to, like, for example, now see this picture here. Now it means if they print it, it's going to be divided, so you have to be conscious of the things that you put in on this divider. Now if you don't like this layout, you can decide to just click here, just click, keep clicking till you are okay with whatever layouts that they give to you. For example, now I like this layout, right? So I can just double click inside. When I double click, I can just double click to open up. Like, I want to increase the size now, so I can just double click on my workspace, and then this comes up. Now I can select all of these images and then drag to fill up my workspace. Now pay attention to this line also. I don't want it to cross this line, so I can just drag and drop it there. I select this one also, drag and then drag and drop. Then when I'm done, I just click on back. So now I have my page one done, which is spread one. Now I go to the spread two and then continue adding images. So I can come add a bit of my of the bride, add here my brother. Now I tried to add, but then it went to this image, so I'll just Ctrl Z, then make sure I am on this one, make sure like I have this one selected, right? So and then I just double click again, and then it should add into this one. Now remember the thing I said about that border, this is it. Now if you notice, every image has red over it, has red on them. That's the border that's added at the beginning. So if you want to add border, now you see what border looks like, you can decide to say I want to add it, but I don't want to add it. So now back here, so I've added this one. Now most times when I'm doing portraits, the most image that I can bring in is 6, right? Unless maybe I'm running out of space and I still have more images for portraits, but most pictures that I bring in is 6, and I arrange them like this. So this one, this two, this is three, this is four, this is five, excuse me, and this is 6, right? So these are usually arranged them, three on one side, three on one side, right? So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now if I'm good with this arrangement, if you want to shuffle, you can still click here and then shuffle, but I'm good with this arrangement. So I just go to the next layout. Now for this one, let me add 5, so I can do 1, let me see this one, okay, 2, Shianamon, 3, let me see, 4, and then, okay, let me do 4, wait, let me do 3, let me undo it, 3. Now see this image, now you see this white line I'm talking about now. And remember I said be careful with the kind of images that come there. Now on this image now, I know this white line is not on anybody's face, right? So it might not be a problem like this. But if I now fill up, okay, let me see, when I fill up now, right, you see it's not on anybody's face. So even if they print and you open, you have these people on one side, these people on one side. So it's not much of a problem. You can decide to like this. So that's all for this slide. So now I've done 3 spread. Now depending on how many pages you want to give to your clients, if you tell them that okay, I'm giving 50 pages, you know you're working with 25 spread. If you tell them, oh, I'm giving 40 pages, you know you're working with 20 spread. Right? So now I'm on my 3rd spread. Now this 3 spread now is 6 pages. So I have page 1, page 2, page 3, page 4, page 5, page 6. I hope that's understandable. So you keep doing this till you get to your 20 spread or however. So let's say I'm giving just let's say I tell my clients I'm giving them 20 sheets, so I'm working with just 10 spread. So I'm going to do so let me just start filling up. So on this one I can do, so now let me put in 12 images. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, some self landscape images, you see the way everything just everything just fits in, right? So let's say so let's say these are group pictures. Now I already have everything fitted into one spread. Now if there are more pictures, I can still go and then add all over again. So now I have 4 spreads done. I have six spread left. So you can continue again. Oh, okay. Now see, here's something. Now, like I said, most times you try to arrange, you try to tell a story, right? So now, on this event, the groom came much later for the bride. Okay, no, I was able to take pictures of the groom much later, and then him and his bride. Now, what I would do now is, see this two spread, this spread that is here now, I won't delete it, right? I'll just come, because I want, after bride, you have groom, then bride and groom, right? So I'm going to add in the groom's images now. So let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So now these are the groom images, and I want him to be directly after his wife. So I can just come up here, I can just come to his spread, click on this arrow here, and then drag him back. So I have the bride, I have the groom. Or better still, let me move this up a bit, sorry. Or better still, you see from your arrangement here, you can just easily rearrange. So this is the groom's image, you can just bring it down, and then it becomes the last spread, right? So this is his image, I want him to be after his wife, so I can just click and then bring him behind, I mean, in between these two spread. So I have the bride, and then so let's bring in bride and groom together, the couple together. So I can say, oh, I still have images of the groom. Trying to bring it down back. So I still have images of the groom. So I can just do, if I feel like almost of the images here are the same, for example, this image, and this image look the same, I can just switch images. I can take one from here and then drag into. Okay, for this one, I don't like the light that is behind, so I can replace this one with another image. Now to replace, I just click on the image and then drag it into the one you want to replace it with, right? And then you drop it, it automatically replaces it. So I want to replace another one with one of these ones, so I can just click this one and then drag it into the one I want to replace it with, and then that's it. So we continue with your design. Now I want to add the groom and the bride. So I can just click on this, then click 1, 2. Okay, for this one now, I'm going to do them on 2 spread. One is going to be 5 images, one is going to be 6 images. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? Now, pay attention to this line once again, right? Because this line now is slightly dividing the groom, and I don't want it. So I can see, let me replace it with this image and see what I get. Okay, now it's cutting up the bride, but not so much. So what I can do is, now come to this big spread here. I want to move their image more into the right to bring up more space here. So I'll just come here and then move to the right, so I have more space on the left. Exactly, because like I said, I'm paying attention to this divider here, so I don't want some of their image to be cut out. So I'll just move them towards the right to bring up more space on the left. Now I have 5 images on this one. The next one I can do. Okay, the next one, let me do 2. I can do 1, 3. So make sure you're on this one, click on it, and then do 1 and 2. Right, so for this one now, I can decide to make them a perfect square. So I can just click on one, and then use it to fill up. Click on another one, and then use it to fill up. Right, but this one, I don't like this one because it's cutting part of the girl. So let me just click on back, and then look for an image to replace with. So I like this one, just click and drag, and then drop it inside. So now if I feel like I want to bring them down a bit, I'll just click on the image, come back to this place, and then drag them down. So now we're at 7 spreads already. so I can continue again, so I can now start adding more pictures. So you can do 6 in a page, 7, 8, 9, but the highest I do is 12. So you can just click and select, randomize your selection. So I have how many here? 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so you can just click here to shuffle and then choose whichever one you want. Now notice that most of my images, I'm allowing them hit the edge, like get close to the edge. It's not a must, it's just how I do it. It's not a must that they have to touch the edge totally. For example, you can have how many bits are here? 6. 6. Okay, let me add an extra one. Okay. So let me just shuffle. Okay. You can have pictures like this that don't touch the edge. It's your choice. Right, so I have 8 spread, I have 2 spread left. So let me just fill them up with any picture. Let me just fill them with any picture so we can export. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Maybe 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So you can still click and then randomize again. Just keep going through to your code, whichever one. If you like this one, you move to the next spread, which is this. Click on it, then add some last pictures. And let me just go back and add. Okay, now I have one more spread left, right? But now I've used up all my pictures. I've gotten to the last picture. So I feel like I want to add some images from here, from this point. So I can just click 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? But now I will not leave this picture here because she has already changed to her outfit here. So what I'll just do is click on this one and then drag it to where I want it to be, right? So I'm going to come down to this point and then pay attention to where I switched her clothes. Okay, this is spread 5. She was still wearing the same clothes here, and this is spread 10, the same clothes. So I'll move spread 10 to spread 6, which is after spread 5. So I'll just drag spread 10 and then drop it in between spread 5. So I have spread 5 and then spread 6. Now remember I said I was going to move the couple images. So I want to add them after the groom, which is spread 3. So I'll come to spread 7 and then click and drag. Sorry, and then click it and then drag it after spread 3. Now see this white, there's one white circle that is coming here. It's just telling you, okay, this is where you want to drop it, or yeah, drop it. So I'll drop that here, and then it's now my spread 4. And I'll take this spread 8, which is also the couple, and then drop it between 4 and 5, so it now becomes my spread 5, right? So like I said, I'm trying to flow with the the events. So from beginning we have, so let's start from the beginning. We have our makeup, we have bride in her first outfit, we have groom in his first outfit, we have bride and groom, we also have bride and groom, then bride and her girls, right? And then bride's outing, then from here, bride has changed to her second outfit, still second outfit, and then way to go. So once I'm done, I'll click on this sign which says export. And then it says export for print. So I click on yes, export for print. Now make sure your image is on JPEG. Make sure you have JPEG selected. Color profile sRGB. What output range, like what are you exporting? So you click on all spread. Make sure you have all spread selected. Make sure export as single pages is not selected, because what this is going to do is it's now going to divide it to page 1, page 2, page 3, page 4, page 5. But export them as spread, right? You're exporting them like this. Good. But once, like this, what I mean, export them like this. But once you click on export as single pages, it's going to export them like this. 1, 2. instead of like this, right? So export on spread, then click on export, and then it's just going to take a little bit of time to export. Alright, so once it's done, you just click on, it shows you export is complete, then you click on OK, and it's going to, it should show up where the images are. So this is it. Now it has everything numbered out for you, 01, 02, 03, down to 010. So these are first spread, second spread, third spread, fourth spread, and so on and so forth. So now once you are done with this, next thing is you go to Photoshop or whichever and then design their cover page, and then still save it up inside the same folder, and then send everything to your printers. You can use WeTransfer, Google Drive, WhatsApp, whichever one works for your printers. And so that's pretty much it on how to design a photo book from start to finish.